Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today in this video we will see one of the worked example on creating a calendar in Oracle Primavera P6. So the calendar that I'm going to create today is a 6 day 7 hour calendar, which means weekly 6 days of work. We'll consider Monday to Saturday, 6 days, right? Sunday will be holiday, okay? And daily 7 hours of work. That will be morning 9 a.m. to afternoon 1 p.m. 4 hours. Then we have a lunch break of 1 hour. Then afternoon 2 p.m. to evening 5 p.m. 3 hours here. So 4 plus 3 will be 7 hours of work per day. So I'll close this. So let's open the software. So to create a calendar, you need to go to Enterprise, Calendar. So you will get this kind of dialog box where you can see three radio buttons here: Global, Resource, and Project. Always keep it in Global because the calendars that you create under Global will be available everywhere. You can apply the calendars that you create under Global to activities or any kind any future projects that you create. So keep it under Global. So let's click on Add. So it will ask you to copy one of the existing calendar. So you can't directly create a calendar, you'll have to select one of the existing calendar. Always try to select which calendar is easy to modify for you. So suppose the calendar that I wanted to create was 5 day 9 hour, just imagine, then it will be easier to copy this one. Why because 5 day 8 our calendar, right? You have to just make changes to this 8 hour, so it will be easier to make the changes. So in this case also I will go with the 5 day 8 hour calendar, so I'll click that. So you can see the exact copy of 5 day 8 hour here as a new calendar. So I'll rename it as 6 day 7 hour. So you can see right here 6 to 7 hour. So select the highlight the calendar and click on modify. So you'll get this kind of dialog box where you can see two radio buttons. So keep the radio button in the second one. Now go to work week. So you'll get this dialog box. What you need to do here is that you can see Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, each day of the week here, right? For the each day, it will show the work hours here. So Monday, okay, let's say Sunday. Look at Sunday. If you see this kind of light blue color, it means it's full of non-working hours. So if I click on Monday, you can see right white color here, it indicates the working hour. So Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, again if I go to Saturday, you can see it's full non-work. So we have to make the changes here. So let's do one thing. First select Sunday, then hold the shift key and select Saturday, so that everything gets selected. And here in the working hours, select the first bar and select the shift and hold, select the last bar, so everything gets selected. Click on non-work to get rid of any of the error. I hope you know that this each bar indicates half an hour. See here, the first bar indicates 12 a.m. to 12:30 a.m. This one 12:30 a.m. to 1 a.m. Last bar 11 to 11:30 p.m. 11:30 to 12 a.m. So our working hours will be falling somewhere over here. So now let's make the main changes. We want the 6 day, 7 hours, right? So Monday to Saturday, 6 days I selected. Then the working hours I need to select. So we know 9 to 1, select 9, then shift hold 10, 11, 12, 1, make it working hour. Again, 1 hour of break here, then 2 to 3, 4, 5, 3 hours here. So 9 to 1 and 2 to 5, 7 hours of working day for these many days except Sunday. So click on OK. Now go to time periods here. Here we'll have to make changes manually. It won't get changed automatically. So per day, how many hours of work? Seven hours of work, right? So per week it will be 7 into 6. Daily 7 for 6 days, 7 into 6, which will be 42. Monthly we are considering 4 weeks. That is some standard that we follow in Oracle Primavera. So 42 into 4 will be, let's see, 42 into 4 will be 168. Again, 168 into 12 should be 2016. Click on OK. Click on OK here. Before that, let's come to the first radio button. Now you can see the calendar is ready. We have finished the modifications. Here in the calendar you can see, right, Sunday is the non-working days. This light blue color indicates non-working days. And again here, the gray color indicates the working hours. When you click on one of the working day, it will show how many hours of working hours we have on that particular day. 7. Here if you click, it shows 0. So this is about the creation of calendar. So if you have any doubts, you can comment below. Subscribe my channel for the daily updates. And if you like the video, I'm happy, yes. Okay, thank you.